I don't see how carrying the dread in your country is a problem.
Gigi Oroni Monsofuyi, Cherry Lagos State, your worst.
Let me tell you something. Where you have your property is where your life is.
My take on the medical state of the country, like if I'm to rate the standard of the our state of our medical sector, our system, I'll say that it's below average. The reason I'll say it's below average is one, if the medical state of the country is okay, the president wouldn't have led the country to go outside the country to go and seek a better medical treatment. Since then he entered the administration, he's been flying abroad for any little medical checkup. So that means that even the president did not believe in our medical system. Then currently the doctors are even going on strike. So it's easy to tell you that the medical sector of the country is poor. That there is a very, very need and a very big need for the country to improve on their medical sector. One, equipment. Because Nigerian doctors are abroad, they are performing very well. But one thing is that the question is, why is Nigerian doctors, they are not doing well in Nigeria? One, the equipment, and second, the way they are paid. Some of the attorneys, they are exposed, like this COVID-19, they are the frontline workers. And most of the time, they are not treated well, they are not paid well. That's why they are even on strike. And then if you go to our general hospital, you see that that both the way they relate to the patients, and then the hospital and everything is poor. It's very, very poor. Most of the deaths you're experiencing in Nigeria is not they don't die based on the time they're supposed to die. It's based on that our medical sector is poor. So if I will rate Nigerian medical sector, I will rate them below average, that there's a need for them to improve.
Thank you.
Okay.
I saw that news this morning, but I don't really know if the whole Nigerians cannot voice out that what's really happened to the man in the house. I think he lives with them, the president or so. Okay, he's a driver. But to my own opinion, like, they need to know what really happened to that man, because everybody just can't be silent. Why a personal driver to the man in Buhari, our president, would just die just like that, and we don't really know the cause of the death or something. My opinion is everything in this country is just like kind of upside down to Nisha, because I don't know why the president will be leaving his own country to another man's country just to take treatment. Meanwhile, if you are able to fix the facilities in your own country, there won't be need for all that one now. So that's my own opinion, sir.
This is not the first time the president is leaving this country without any reason. Any genuine reason. As a president, even though something is happening in the nation, we have to make sure we solve the problem with the state. So it's not meant to just leave the country just like that without solving the problem. So it is not encouraging at all. So the governorship of Muhammad Buhari is somehow, I don't know what to call him. So it means his lack of understanding of the political line.
I would say my pick for it is number one, the whole situation of the country, especially with doctors striking, especially when the citizens need them, is totally wrong. And I feel like the government in question should do something about it so that citizens can have good access to good health care. You understand? So that, you know, people will not, when they need that health care and there's emergency, start running around, you know, during emergency cases and have to die in the process. And then the president flying out in such kind of situation is actually not cool. He has to settle the situation in his country before traveling out. I feel the president has to settle that which is in his country before he even flies out to do any medical checkup, because it's the people that voted him into power. So if he allows the people due to emergency crisis to die also, they'll vote him out. So that's like trying to cause another revolution, so after the whole SARS crisis and everything. So it's totally wrong.
Well,
I can't really say much because I have actually lost hope on my president, because this is not what I expected from him, you know. I actually voted for him, but I regretted voting for him because this is not what I expected from him. You can imagine his own driver, his own personal driver, is admitted into Nigerian hospital while him, they fly him abroad for his own medication. Like, he's, I don't know, like, kind of think of it, he's kind of crazy. He can't, I don't think there's any good thing that could come out of him, because if I've already lost the point, I'm not expecting anything from him. Like, I'm actually not in the mood for this president stuff and all that.
All right, thank you.